we are looking for the superintendent at Queens. And our title is very simply entitled Community Awareness. Just to give you a bit of background, Reading and Zellon program coordinator for year one, and have been responsible for a number of years coordinating the nursing modules in year one. And sensory awareness is an important topic. It's something we have always included in our curriculum. We students were talking about the facts and obtain some insight in role play and other such media. But the fact that we are the best way to get this insight was from those who have deficits. And had contact with a gentleman called John Crawford, who is deaf and was a deaf trainer with RNIB, actually, of course, now known as Action for Hearing Loss. He was very keen to come and deliver awareness sessions to our students. But unfortunately, when I approached the hierarchy of that stage, budget constraints prohibited that. You, as you're aware, of the training takes a year, and because there was a cost involved to this, I demanded permission to pursue this venture. Karen then joined the staff of Wild River, and casual conversation one day led to a discussion of how important sensory awareness training was, and how the input from service users would be so effective. Karen had contacts through her prior role with RNIB, and of course I had the contact with John. We decided to try here, and I spent quite a while constructing the email, making sure that the teams across the guys were all initially and sent it all to the next school. This time we got a very positive response, which was clear to get off the road ahead. So the past 2 years we've had a sensory awareness day when the students are about halfway through year one. In the morning we have Charlie, who's blind, and she gives a very entertaining talk to the students and describes her experiences, and including reminding them that a guide dog isn't a tom-tom, you don't say, take me to Sainsbury's, and it gets you there. John, who is deaf, then takes the afternoon session, and he starts off by asking the students how they would identify someone with a disability, and he reminds them that he had come in a wheelchair, he had a disability, or if he had a right stick. So students really enjoyed these opportunities. And through those sessions, actually requested further opportunities to develop that sensory awareness. We now have students undertaking the visual awareness course with the RNIB. This is a booklet that they complete, and then that's followed up by guiding techniques taken by Charlie. This is actually funded through the RNIB. They got some lottery money for that. And then if the students want a certificate, they pay £25. Again, following student requests, John in this session teaches the students some very simple signing, including the alphabet. So at the end of the session, they all know how to sign their own name. So they wanted more of this. So John actually runs a customised sign language course. He customises it for nurses, and he gives them sort of the signing that might be appropriate when you're looking after patients or fans with a sensory deficit. So at the minute, this is a 3-hour session. It actually costs the student £20. Now, personally, I think that we value something and we do have to pay for it. To get the students are more than happy to pay up £20. And both those sessions, actually, students can register for doing this, so that part of the University of Auckland. But it was through this these sessions, it's actually John suggested to me that we produce a pocket-sized e-ink memoir with tips and hints to assist nursing students caring for someone with a sensory deficit. I had a number of years ago produced something like this. I produced a pocket-sized book to assist students in our clinical skills, just to check as your skills. This has actually since then been developed into an app. So you can see how a plan and what was hashed with this idea.
So my name is Karen, Susan's already introduced me. And as John and Charlene, our service user partners, have been unable to attend us today due to sickness and other engagements. We really want to ensure we do this justice for them consent is such an important part of it. Signing here are three most important senses for human mobility, orientation, communication and participation in society. So I just thought if you took a moment and considered if you had to lose a sense, which one would you like to do? So if you look at that, right there, would it be smell? Would it be touch? Would it be taste? Or would you consider hearing? Or sight? And I would suggest that very few of us would consider the literally of sight and hearing. Some facts and figures around this, so 75% of people with sight loss and or hearing loss are over the age of 75. There are almost 2 million people in the UK with sight loss. This figure includes around 360,000 people registered as blind or partially sighted in the UK. There are more than 10 million people in the UK with some form of hearing loss, which equates to 1/6 of the population. About 3 million people in the UK have hearing aids, but only 1.4 million use them. At least 4 million people who don't have hearing aids would benefit from using them. And on average, it takes 10 years for people to address their hearing loss. It goes without saying that the rise in the aging population will ultimately see an increase in these figures, making knowledge and skills around sensory awareness paramount for healthcare professionals, and this is our starting point for the project. And as Susan has alluded to, budgetary constraints meant that we need to think outside the box as to how we can entice someone to fund our project. And luckily for us, the Mark McMahon Scholarship awards the grant to undertake this work. So we had a aim of objectives, and I'll skip the slide, so for our time on this one. The aim was the development of sensory awareness app and a training up for health professionals with 3 objectives to introduce the sensory. little, visual impairment or deficit, are they helpful or are we not being very helpful? Also, she tells about the time she went for a Christmas dinner, and they were all dancing on the dance floor, and they all sat down and forgot to tell her they were sitting down. That's her most embarrassing moment. She's terrible. But she tells these stories, and so does John, with such enthusiasm and such humour. They're not in any way depressed about their illness or their deficit, and the students really engage with that, and they really enjoy the stories. In terms of impact on our nursing students, the following are just some examples of what the students have said about the course. I'll just give you a few minutes to read that yourselves. I've got a 5 minute room now, so I'm going to march on. So, in terms of impact on care delivery, then, the students have told us they are less nervous engaging with patients with a sensory loss. They're conscious of how small adaptations can have a big difference in terms of the quality of patient experience. Social exclusion affects hugely those with a sensory loss. Nearly half of blind and partially sighted people feel modern, they are completely cut off from people and things around them. Hearing loss also impacts on relationships with both the person with the hearing loss and their partner, feeling a sense of isolation and frustration. Sight loss and or hearing loss has a serious impact on the individual's quality of life. And it's our hope that the introduction of this training resource will enable patients to be less isolated in healthcare, as staff become more confident in communicating with patients with a sensory deficit. This is just some of our service users' thoughts. And as I said at the beginning, it took up to 10 years for a person with hearing loss to take action. I can remember teaching a course recently when the student only informed me at the end of the year that she had hearing problems, and she had sometimes found it very hard to keep up with the class discussion. And I felt really bad as I thought that she was just something like to be quiet. So this episode highlighted to me yet again that we don't necessarily know when someone's suffering from hearing loss or vision loss. It's not always that obvious. So what does the future hold? Well, the app is being developed and this needs evaluated. The School of Nursing and Queens is a well-established service user forum that we began to use to engage our users in both the classroom teaching and assessment in all phases of nursing. Our ultimate goal is to make this a offer package available for all health professionals, and my woman and our students will show you some of the app.
Hello,
the
of what is available. All our computer devices will be. So this should just be one, this arm or something. Possible to take it. But anyway, this can be downloaded to your smartphone, you can be downloaded to your iPad or whatever. Some sample pictures there, which you see. chair and search for names and so on, and John, because through the alphabet, because through different words, maybe words that you would be using as a nurse or a carer, some phrases, you know, this is your bed space, here's your toilet, this is the directions to the toilet, I need your medication, or whatever. So different signs like that, which unfortunately we haven't been able to show you despite all the plans and our help from our computer technician. But initially we set out to develop a multimedia package to aid our nursing students to develop sensory runs and give them the necessary information and skills to engage with patients and plans in the multimedia. But it is our hope that once we provide you, that you will be able to learn to all nursing healthcare professionals. From our initial contacts with Joel and Charlie, and our hope that they would increase our students' awareness of what it's like to have sensory deficit, we now have a partnership in place. And in fact, John sent me an email, and I'm quoting here, said, "Can I ask you to apologise to the participants of the conference, as I am unable to attend today, but can you, on my behalf, mention the value of the